New video tonight shows a massive fireball shooting out of a Boston brownstone. And now the awful news, two firefighters are dead.
CBS 2's Joe Shortsleeve has more now on the dangerous conditions the men faced that ultimately cost them their lives.
We know tonight that the first report of a fire was a 911 call, someone reporting smoke in the building. We also know tonight that there were no sprinklers in the building, technically not required, but they sure could have made a difference yesterday. The focus tonight, the flames and the 45-mile-an-hour winds. From the river, you can see the ice-encrusted shell, which housed 8 units. Yesterday, for some unknown reason, the brownstone exploded in flames, claiming the lives of two brave firefighters. Killed 43-year-old Lieutenant Ed Walsh and 33-year-old Michael Kennedy, who both worked just a few blocks away at the fire station on Boylston Street. Today, firefighters could be seen high above Beacon Street, inspecting the roof of the burnt-out structure.
It was scary.
Nate Fletcher lives directly across the street and took in terrified residents who escaped the burning building.
They said they smelled smoke, saw fire, and then just got out of the house.
Investigators believe the two firefighters became trapped in a massive surge of heat and flames known as a backdraft. They believe it happened when a window broke in the front of the four-story brownstone about 3 p.m. Wednesday.
There was some kind of extraordinary event happened in the basement.
When the flames exploded, firefighters could be heard on the radio, desperately trying to get everyone out.
Engine 33 has a mayday on channel 2 in the basement. Engine 33 is mayday in channel 2 in the basement, okay?
I want all members out of the building.
It was a mayday. It would indicate something extraordinary happened.
There are two apartments in the walkout basement area on the river side of the building where Kennedy and Walsh became trapped. There's a heating unit, a laundry room, and an elevator located right there. The elevator was installed in 1996. All are possible sources of the fire. Investigators from the Boston Fire Department and the Suffolk County District Attorney's Office say the formal investigation could take months. We've also learned tonight that this building is in a family trust, and that trust has been the subject of nasty legal battles dating back all the way to 1987. In Boston, Joe Shortsleeve, CBS 2 News.
13 other firefighters were hurt, and several police officers were also taken to the hospital. There were no reports of any injured residents.